Alright, hello world. This is Kim. Welcome to Pinoy Wargamer. And yeah, Privateer Press Prime has dropped a video, The Art of Privateer Press. I'm assuming this is for their art book, which they have up on Kickstarter. So, let's see what it's all about.
Players of Privateer's games have been asking for an art book for years, almost since the beginning when we were publishing RPG books and we had just done Witchfire. It was always something that we wanted to do, but we always knew that there was another project. One of our objectives for every product that we've ever done is to fill it with artwork and just make it as lush and lavish as possible.
Now we've got tons of art to pull from.
It is true. I am one of those people who have always wanted an art book from Privateer Press. They have a really, really good set of artists that have a nice visual grasp of what War Machine and Hordes and the Iron Kingdoms look like.
Like literally thousands of pieces. The approach now is take the best of everything that we've done and put it into one big book. I could hand it to somebody and they would really see what our world building and our creativity is all about. Where it all started was the Iron Kingdoms RPG, then we got into War Machine, later Hordes, where every one of those books had literally dozens and dozens of pieces of artwork.
One of the first projects that I worked on was level 7. By that time, a bunch of pre-production and visual development had been done, and there's a lot of artwork that actually didn't even make its way into any of the games that you've seen.
Monster Apocalypse was another one where we did tons of concept artwork, we had illustrations for every faction in the game, and then the Bodger stuff, we had so much fun.
With 144 pages, we're only going to be able to fit a few hundred illustrations, and we have thousands to choose from. Is there any way that we could maybe up that page count a little bit?
Yeah. We've woven that right into the Kickstarter. And the stretch goals, we've set goals at certain increments that will add more signatures and pages to the book. Every one of those signatures is going to allow us to put in dozens more pieces of artwork.
I noticed that one of the things we've got set up in the set of the stretch goals is for a special new cover.
Yes, yeah. If the project funds far enough beyond the original goal, one of
I've seen like Hydro's special covers for 5th edition D&D. Those are amazing. I know a lot of PP's artists can pull something like that or similar. They're talking about an alternate cover. So is the Kickstarter supposed to be just like to kickstart the project? And then they will have it on retail for normal folk like me. Because I'm assuming if you back this up on Kickstarter and then you hit that pledge level, you get a nice alternate cover.
The lofty goals is that we'll actually produce an all new original piece of artwork just for the art book.
And you can do it.
That remains to be seen. I'm a little rusty.
So, what was behind the decision to...
This is that big one. The James Mini looks like Iron Mother with tons of spikes. It's solo. Dan posted the stats up on the Facebook group.
Using Iron Maiden for this book.
You know the original piece of artwork.
Yes, I do. Yeah, that's black and white drawing with spikes forever, and there's no way in hell that it could ever be produced as an action.
Yeah, which is why it never made it onto the tabletop before. When you put it on the War Machine table, she can be used with every faction.
Oh, so
she's a robot, so she doesn't have
much. Look at those quick stylized wrist blade.
There's been so much evolution. including with our characters, where each iteration of a character as they evolve throughout the timeline. Are we planning on showing anything like that?
Oh yeah, I think that's one of the most interesting things that we're gonna be
Sorsha,
to be able to show all of the different expressions of some of these iconic characters that have literally had lifespans of 5, 10,
that's
15
spacious,
years.
Baby.
Go back to the beginning and show the very first concepts.
Look at that guy.
We're really excited about this project. It's been years in the making, and we hope that anybody who has ever been a fan of the Arbor Privateer Press will join us on this project.
Is that it?
I know, I'm going to be donating.
You'll probably get one for free.
What? Alright. There you go, Art of Privateer Press. Me? I have been a fan of PP art for the longest time. I have some reservations on improvement, but that's just me. Nonetheless, I like it. It's been those like Sorsha, Asphyxius, old prime pieces. Those are iconic. Brings me back in the day. Mark One. The Kickstarter will end soon, so if you're a fan of getting the art book and the special miniature, the Iron Maiden, go on right ahead and go back to that project. I will try. Let me figure out my finances. That's it. Kick ass with honor, game with glory. I'm out.